Hi, let us understand how to do the installation of Vault. Vault can be downloaded from the website vaultproject.io, where I do have the download option. Vault can be downloaded as a binary and it can be installed in different operating systems like macOS, Windows, Linux, and various flavors of Linux. In case if I wanted to download the source code and compile them, I can very well do that. And the instruction how to compile and get that executed, it's available as a part of the documentation. In this particular course, we will be seeing the options of installing it as a binary as well as the packages. I'm going to demonstrate the installation both in Windows as well as in a sample Linux operating system. For Windows, I can download the binary. Here I can choose the architecture that I wanted and click download. That's going to download a zip file. Once the zip is extracted, it's going to have a single file. The downloaded zip file is extracted in this specific location. I do have an exe. As such, within the production, we will be having a cluster of servers, that is Vault running in multiple systems, so that I will be getting high availability. But for learning purpose, I am going to start the Vault in a single system. And that also I will be starting in the developer mode, so that I will be having multiple options, like the server will be pre-configured and it will be very useful for the testing as well as the POC purpose. Since it's in the unsealed state, it's not safe and secure to be used in production. And every data will be there as a part of memory. And once if I restart the server, the data will get erased. And as such, while starting the server, Vault will get unsealed automatically and the initial root token will also get generated. We will see what this root token and unsealing later point of time. And it's going to have a key value store. That's where the actual secrets will get stored and that will get mounted automatically. Now I do have the Vault extracted and I do have a single exe file. I can execute this in a PowerShell or in a command prompt. Here I do have the file vault.exe. I can execute this Vault file and it's going to provide the command options. That means the execution is good. And in case if I wanted this particular command to get executed in any location, I can add this as a part of the system environmental variable. This particular path, I can add it as a part of the system properties, advanced system settings, environment variable, and within the path, I can edit the path and create a new path and add the path where I do have the exe and save, so that the Vault command can be executed from any location. And getting this help, it's a confirmation I do have the installation good, and let me go ahead and start the server in the developer mode. Vault.exe server-deb. Within Vault, we do have a concept like client and server. Within the developer mode, the same machine will be acting as a server as well as the client. We will discuss more in detail about what is server, what is client, and how that will be leveraged within the production environment. It's going to start with the predefined configurations. So this is the port where it is going to get started, and the recovery mode will be in the false state and the storage will be in memory. This is the version of the Vault that is getting started. And for the system to understand at what address the Vault is running, I need to add this particular environmental variable. Let me open a new shell. I can open the shell in any location, and in case if I am executing the command as a part of the PowerShell, I need to provide the environmental variable by this particular syntax, and I can check the status of the Vault. So I can provide the command vault.exe status. It is initialized and it's up and running. Let's not worry about the seal type, sealed status, number of shares, threshold, all such details. Let's not worry about it. Now I do have Vault to work on. And we do have a beautiful UI to work with Vault that's going to run in the local host port 8200. That will be asking for the password to log in. I can use any of this particular way. Whenever the server is getting started, it's going to provide a root token. So as a part of the log output, here I do have a root token. I can copy this root token and enter over here. and it's going to take me to the UI screen of Vault. This warning I can ignore because I have logged in as a root token and that needs to be changed. That we will be doing it later. Here I can have access to various options like secret, access details, policies and various tools. With this we are able to install Vault and make it up and running as a part of the Windows operating system. In the next lecture, we will see how to do the installation within a Linux operating system.